Truthchaser, reporting for who? For no one. Because one person can make a difference, and self-empowerment is what it's key out here. The live interviews, the one-on-one interviews, just basically picking people's brains, seeing what they think, see if they realize that they're basically in a mental prison, zombies, if you want to call them that. Conditioned to basically be on their cell phones, you know, so cell phones, computers, laptop, you name it, they're on it. No human-human interaction. People basically are emotionally dead. Is this the end of humanity as we speak? Probably. That's what Bill Gates wants. I mean, that's what a lot of elitists want. But, you know, again, we're going to pick people's brains. We're going to see exactly what makes them tick. Ask them, how do you feel about cell phones? How do you feel about technology today? How do you feel about yourself? And more importantly, are we being dehumanized? Getting down and dirty in the desert city. We see a lot of people nowadays, right? And a lot of people, this is real talk, a lot of people are on their fucking cell phones. A lot of people don't communicate with each other. When we go on a bus, what are people doing? They're like this, they're texting and shit like that, right? How do you feel about that?
It makes me sad. They won't even put their cell phone down to talk to their grandmother or have dinner or...
Nothing, right?
Yeah, and they're always on their phones. They're not looking up at the sky.
They're not looking at the chemtrails. They're not looking at that either.
That's right.
They're not looking at what's going on in the food.
That's right.
Nothing like that,
they're
right?
They're distracted.
Why are people distracted?
They choose to be.
out of ignorance.
Yeah.
Out of ignorance. Well, thank you so much.
Thank you.
It's fucking amazing because, you know, excuse me, I'm all like spitting everywhere, but, but because, you know, you're awake. And what do you think it's going to take for people to wake up and realize that we're being dehumanized by the government?
It's going to take a collective consciousness. It's going to take everybody to do their part. And that's the hard part is...
It is the hard part.
It's not one person.
Do you think it's going to happen or we're all going to just, like, crash into this, like, fucking...
I think there'll be sides. I think there'll be us.
There's going to be the rich versus the poor, no more middle class, right?
Yeah.
Why do most people choose their cell phones over interacting with other people, do you know?
Why is that?
I don't know. Does it seem like, you know, you're a performer, you're out here, you're singing, you're a performer,
yeah.
You're making money, you're doing your thing, and people just seem zombified, they don't want to interact.
Right.
All people want to do nowadays are get on a PS4, or get on an Xbox One. It's like dehumanization. I mean, do you see that, or don't you see that?
I do see that sometimes, you know?
You do.
I mean, there's an element of that.
Like, we are across here, you know, you don't want to see 6 or 7 people out of 12 sitting on their cell phones with their, you know.
It's like a
drug. It's kind of almost like, you know, if I want to get drunk to escape reality, or someone to smoke weed to escape reality.
Right.
It's kind of like they say, hey, look, we'll give you these getcha gadgets to escape fucking reality. We're tired of your bullshit. You're not dehumanizing us anymore. This is PT, Prince Truthchaser. We're out here, Truthchaser. We're singing, we're dancing, we're bringing love vibration, we're bringing awareness of dehumanization. Is it going to happen now? You're with your dog.
These people need to cheer up a little bit more. Okay. No matter what, something else is always worse.
Something else is always worse.
Yeah, that's right.
We look at everyone, we see everybody, everybody's on their cell phones, right? Everybody's distracted. I mean, it seems like a dehumanization, if you want to call it that. Like, people are unhumanized from themselves,
right.
and they're either in their cell phone or on video games, or they're doing something.
Exactly.
You think that's the case?
It takes a part of it, yeah.
Why do you think that's the case?
People are more... It does interfere.
Yeah,
I don't let it interfere me, so right. I don't know how bad it is.
So you as an individual wouldn't... You know, you wouldn't be on your cell phone 24 hours a day. If someone wanted to talk to you like I'm talking to you, you would talk to them. You wouldn't talk to them with a text message, right?
No.
That's good.
We're talking about the corrupt government, and we're talking about how they want to dehumanize us through our radios, through our TVs, through our cell phones, through me even talking to you right now. They want to watch it up through Facebook, so that way we don't interact with each other, we don't talk to each other, we don't have synchronicity with each other. How do you feel about that, my friend? How do you feel about that?
That's bullshit.
You think that should be stopped? You think that should be stopped?
Yeah.
I mean, think about it. In order to destabilize the people, you have to separate the people, right or wrong?
Mm-hmm.
You have to separate the people, right? And it seems like people bickering, people arguing. How do you feel?
That's not right. Bullshit.
What do you think is going to take to change the bullshit, man?
need to change ways. People need to change ways.
We need to change ways? We need to unite, you think so? And we need to take back the power that they're trying to take from us.
Yep.
Another Prince Truthchaser moment. Be about it, live about it, feel it in your heart, or shut the fuck up. 100% of the time, we go on the train or the bus, right? What are people doing?
When they get on?
When they get on, when they're on, they're on their what? Their phones. You walk up to someone and you say, hey, excuse me, sir, what's the time? They have no idea because they're on their phone. You know, and I purposely think it's made up that way so that way we won't interact with each other, you know? Think about how mean people are in general. I mean, if someone walks by you, you know, even if they're not on their phone, right? And you say hi, they give you that, you know, that look, you know? And I think that it's purposely done to, like, you know, people escape reality through their cell phones, you know? What do you think?
Good outlook.
You think it's a real outlook or not?
Yeah, oh, definitely. Oh, definitely.
What makes you think that?
Because you're not the only one that thinks that way. I mean, a lot of people know that technology in general is definitely taking us away from human interaction, you know what I mean? That one-on-one, people used to, you know, you never needed a cell phone to live your life. Now it's almost, you don't have a cell phone. In certain aspects of life, you have to have it. They make it where it's not a want anymore, it's a necessity.
It's a necessity.
You see what I'm saying?
Sure.
So,
what do you think? What do you think for the future for us? I mean, do you think it's going to destroy us, or?
I don't think it's going to make it any. I don't think it's going to, you know, put a positive connotation on shit that is going to go on in the future. I'll tell you that.
Yeah.
Do I think it's going to destroy us? I maybe haven't thought, you know, that far into.
Maybe it already is in a way. You know.
Yeah, it could definitely already.
100% of the time, we